Good morning, everyone. A Fox 8 exclusive. The first one to see the Gulf of the Sea in. Did I get it right, Chris?
That was pretty close.
The Gulf of the Sea in poison dart frog right here at the Cleveland Metroparks. We're in the rainforest, and it's free today. F-R-E-E, free. So come on out and check it out. Okay, Chris, these guys literally, they just got, well, the exhibit's only been up 2 days.
Only 2 days.
That's really cool. So if you guys can see them, now these guys are from?
They're from a very small region of Costa Rica, right by the Gulf of Dulce.
Okay, gotcha. Which is the word, Gulf of Dulce. Now, you said these, in the wild, these guys are pretty toxic in terms of poison, right?
They're the most, they're the fourth most toxic in their genus. Mm-hmm. And they show that for you by being so brightly colored. They got that bright orange stripe there, and that's a warning. Just like a bee has those bright yellow and black stripes, that's a warning not to touch me.
Yeah, and because I'm poison.
Right. However, they get their poison from the food they eat. So in the wild, they eat like little beetles and ants that have a toxin of their own, and they convert that inside their body, and they excrete it through their skin.
That's pretty cool.
But here in captivity, we feed them fruit flies, crickets, things that have no toxin of their own.
So they're non-toxic.
They're non-toxic here. But the great thing is they still think they're poisonous, so they sit out in the wild.
So they walk around like this. Yeah.
I'm like, poisonous. You're not going to mess with me. Yeah. I'm brightly colored.
Yeah, they're not really poisonous at all. Now, this is another cool toad. Check this guy out. This is the Puerto Rican crested toad. All right. Now, these guys are pretty interesting because you guys are working with a little program to maybe breed these.
Yeah. So every year we breed and release several thousand tadpoles from these guys.
Okay.
In Puerto Rico, their biggest threat is habitat loss. Mm-hmm. Some predators that have been introduced. And if you were just to like, so what they're actually doing is they're making new ponds down there. If you were just to take some adult toads from Puerto Rico, toss them in the pond and say make babies, they would just go home. They would just go overland to get back to their home.
Okay.
However, we breed 2,000-4,000 tadpoles here, and we ship them down to Puerto Rico along with a bunch of other zoos.
Yeah.
And it's an instant population for those ponds.
That's
and
really cool.
They grow up there and they know to come back to it, and we're doing our part to help get them back.
Chris,
in the wild,
that is awesome. Jax, 10 seconds, come over here, talk about the VIP party.
Absolutely. So we're here with a couple of our friends, Prince Charming and Cinderella today. Mm-hmm. We have our Fairy Tales and Frogs event coming up here February 18th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m.
Mm-hmm. And the VIP party.
And the VIP experience, tea party experience up at Stillwater Place. That is an extra ticket that you can secure today at futureforwildlife.org. You'll enjoy a tea party lunch, story time, take-home craft, cookie decorating, princess dance party. A lot of fun for the whole family.
Awesome stuff. Thank you, Jax. Thank you, Chris. Chris told me you guys that just if you were to put the tip of your tongue on that frog that just got here, and they're in the endangered species list, tip of your tongue in the wild, kill you like that.
Oh, wow.
I thought you were going to say it turns into a prince.
Yeah, right? No. That you have to kiss.
Give me a prince in your next life.
Boy, yeah, you will be fast.